first season and served as the referee's team manager for the past four seasons, handling numerous day-to-day activities for Turtles. Earning the title of head manager as a sophomore, he acted as a consistent presence on the referee bench and is slated to graduate this upcoming summer. Accompanied by his mother, Peggy, and brother, Shane, let's welcome to the hardwood our student manager, Nick.
Nicholls back in action here today, back at Stouffer Gym, trying to win a sixth straight home game here today. Are the Nicholls State University Colonels. They welcome in Central Arkansas. Nicholls looking to get a 10th conference win here this evening, opening to 10-2, trying to sweep the season series over the Bears of Central Arkansas. And a pleasant good evening to you on the Colonel Sports Radio Network. Jack Benjamin on hand, Nicholls and UCA, the Colonels coming in 12-6, 9-2, fourth place right now in the Southland Conference. And UCA 3-15, they are 2-8 in Southland play and have lost 8 consecutive games. The Colonels were supposed to play on Wednesday against Northwestern State, a game that ended up not happening due to the weather that we have had here in Thibodeau, and not just in Thibodeau, all throughout the Gulf Coast, and of course, really Texas, what they had to endure. I don't think Texas has had a day above 30 degrees on the east side of the state. It feels like a week. So a lot of tough things from a circumstance standpoint. Northwestern State unable to get over from Mackinac on Wednesday. And the result is that game getting moved to part of the first. But Colonels back in action on the last couple of days of rest. And they were trying to get a win here today. They did beat Central Arkansas in Conway back on January the 16th. Being a 74-72 final, when Nicholls actually had a lead that was as many as eight early in the first half. UCA took a 5-point lead late in the second, and the Colonels, thanks to some solid shooting down the stretch, they were 40% in the second half, but made six of their final eight shots on the floor. Ended the game with 9-2, and away from a 2-point win at the end. UCA had a late shot, so that really wasn't quite that close. Nicholls' last game at Southeastern on Saturday, a game in which they had to go to overtime. First overtime game of the season for the Colonels. They shot the ball well all throughout, 55%. Southeastern was 46%. You might ask, well, how did Southeastern hang around in the game? A couple of numbers. Number one, the Southeastern defense was terrific. Nicholls 8-21, pretty good mark. Southeastern made 25-30. Turned it over 16 times. Nicholls didn't capitalize well on all those turnovers. And Nicholls was able to find the ball at the very end. They got 30 points per round. He was safe. 12 of 20 shooting from the floor. Jalen Ford's 15 more points per game. He's been improving over his past couple games. And they also had two other double figures, Kevin Johnson and Chris Jackson. The last couple of games. Central Arkansas meanwhile comes up a 40-point loss in San Diego. They have lost eight straight games. Last week, January the 6th today, against New Orleans. That's 6 weeks ago. And they did a win over about 15 days' time in total. They lost their starting point guard, DeAndre Jones, in that game. He's been in. He's an all-conference player. And they just have not been the same offensively since. With him, they weren't off to a great start of the season. They've been struggling in South Florida. They started offensively. They're one of the best teams in the conference. And now they just cannot find their footing without him in the lineup, which now spans the course of pretty much, it's technically 9 games. It's really, it's technically 8 games, I should say, 9 games. They are averaging just about 60 points per game and shooting the ball once per night. It has been a big time struggle. They are hoping to get back on track here at Lakers. It's not been easy for them. It's given them all time. Nicholls 11-3 here at home against Central Arkansas. And have won the last, let's see, the last 4 meetings overall. And now 6 of the last 7. We'll take a break here, come back into the starting lineups for today. Again, Nicholls at 12-6, 9-2 in the South, and 4th place chasing Sam Houston, SFA. Saturday, so Nicholls the only team that plays today. They get that 10-win number and put a little pressure on the teams that are behind them in the standings. Take a break, come back at 60, get to the starters. Nicholls and UC around the corner.
Nice job with the team. Just has been tough. You know, if you're starting point guard and all-conference player DeAndre Jones, not easy. And he's hoping
Nicholls, meanwhile, 12-6, 9-2 in the South of Calgary. Currently chasing Abilene Boomers. Same as the state's contending group sitting at the top. And SFA is ineligible for postseason this year at 9-1. So they're half a game back of SFA, a game back of Sam Houston and Abilene in the loss column. And here's how Nicholls look. Save 5. We have seen now 8 times this season. And it's senior day for Nicholls. They start off with a minus Najee Garvin. He's still celebrating his senior day because he has to
Jones for three, looking. Stoney, Joe Nicholls, 2-2
straight on 16 footers on the break. Rebound, Ashley Garvin. Nicholls wants to push. Right wing, Garvin slows it down. South of Calvert's part of the week. Now accelerates right baseline. Up top, Ashley Garvin's sweet pass to Ty Gordon. Left wing triple. Off the right of Mix. Ryan Burgers in the rebound. Nicholls with some great looks early to get the Central Arkansas team that allows team to shoot about 45%. They've struggled on the defensive side before. Ryan Burgers in meanwhile responds. From the right wing, it's a three. Southland College's fourth leading scorer, 16.6 per game, is a senior out of Boise, Idaho. And the lead for Nicholls down to 2-5-3, 2 minutes, 15 seconds in. Ty Gordon up top, Rocky Lyons on the hoist, and three, spikes it through. Corks a three and buries it. So Raji's got a three-pointer. His first of the season, actually second of the season, and his second of his career. Raji's fifth of his career. Nicholls 8-3 up early, about 2.5 minutes in. Colin Cooper wants a screen at the top of the arc. Gets KJ between the rings, throws a pass left side. Chatham, I should say, is off the mark on a left wing jump shot. Rebound down to Lyons, up ahead Ty Gordon. Left wing Andre Jones pumps a pass, fires away on a triple, pinballs out. Rebound down to Chatham in Central Arkansas. Bergerson up ahead in the lane, kick out. Ty Gordon, Taraji Lyons, left hand Kevin Johnson. He fires up a three and connects. What a start for the Colonels. 11-3 first. They're hopping around. 16-39 first half. Nichols lighting up three, the three of six. Anthony Boone wants a 30-second timeout. That will, I believe, turn into a 60. No indication yet of that. So we will hang with it here. 16-39 again in the first half. A couple things we need to mention. Step slow getting the tip off there, but our referee today, Danny Chan, spoke alongside Coach Dixon, round out on officiating. The all-time series, by the way, at least since Nicholls joined the Southland Conference, favors the Colonels 18-10. They are 11-3, I mentioned, all-time here at Stouffer's Gym. And Nicholls has won the last 4 here in Thibodaux, last at Martin, so when you get to go back January 23rd, 2016. UCA losers of 8 consecutive games. They have not won a road game since their conference opener January 2nd against McNeese. But one thing about this team, they play hard. Anthony Boone, far about the job he's done, and he was dealt a tough hand, but doing a nice job with the group he has, especially without his starting point guard. So, Nicholls Arkansas with it to our right. That timeout, shot clock's down to 5 for Cooper. He slips at the top of the arc, finds Bergerson, right wing, hoists up a 3. It spins out, offensive rebound for 2. In the paint, lost the ball, taken back, tipped around, and Andre Jones corrals. Here comes Nicholls on the run. Kevin Johnson slows it down against Kyle Oates, steps back for a 3. That's all he could. Bounced a couple times into the left, Kyle Oates. 15-50, turn first half clock. 11-3 lead for Nicholls. Colin Cooper. A jump shot from about 18 yards. He's averaging 11 points per game in his return to the lineup. 5 games so far. Played in 27 as a freshman. 7 starts. Forced into the lineup. He's the point guard with DeAndre Jones out. Ty Gordon misfires on the top of the D3 off the backboard. Kyle Lou rebounds. Here comes UCA. 11-5 lead for Nicholls. About 5 minutes into this opening half. Comes the season with 5-1. 2 left block. Double team comes from Kevin Johnson. Lost the ball, taken away by Ty Gordon. Ty gets Chatham on his hip, drives inside. High on the window with the right-handed scoop again. Ty Gordon off to an aggressive start early, 4 points. And Nicholls leads by 8. 13-5. About 5-10. Chatham, left wing against Ty Gordon, has a size advantage, goes right at him. Left hand too strong off glass. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Chatou. And then I'll go back to Nicholls, the other side of our first media timeout. 14-41 to play here at Stouffer. In this first half, Nicholls 13, since long as a 5 girls are shooting very well so far. Been 3-3 games already. 5-10-4. And an 8-point lead to the girls.
Official sports best provider of Nicholls Athletics. Raising hands, one love. Lauren Stanley. For over 80 years, Morgan Stanley has served as a global leader in wealth management. Global advisors Tim Emerson and Martin Reed Knight, proud supporters of Nicholls Athletics. The law offices of Benjamin Cooper. Off the Hook, the official Cajun restaurant of Nicholls Athletics. People's Health, your Medicare health team. The Louisiana Lottery, need a reason to smile. Adidas, the official outfitter of Nicholls Athletics. Adidas is all in. And Louisiana's Cajun Bayou, your Cajun lifestyle is unlike any other. Visit our website at lacajunbayou.com to learn more. Colonels value their corporate partners and thank them for their support.
Due to weather, was supposed to be a three-game homestand, but to a 13-5 burst here against Seminole. It's up 14-41 to go in this first half. A couple subs have come on for Nicholls, so it's Jones along with Garvin and Gordon, three starters. Then Chris Spencer and Jalen Thorns have checked in. Chris Najee Garvin left baseline, matched up against Jonas Munson. Goes to the paint, righty hook, short. Rebound, Chatham, and here comes Central Arkansas. They've also subbed in a couple. Khalid Bent is on. Mentioned Munson is in the game as well. Richard Carter. He's a 7 footer, so Nicholls better keep him off the glass. 14-12 first half, Cardinals up 13-5. UC Angels purple jerseys with the white lettering and trim matte. Bergerson backing up against Aubrey Jones with the in block logo at midcourt. Now with the left wing as his rookie guard steps back, gets Jones up in the air, throws a foul. It's a crafty NBA like maneuver from Bergerson. It's a terrific play. Shot was maybe 5 feet short of the basket, but no foul. That'll be two free throws coming from Bergerson. 57 on the first half clock, 13-5 lead for Nicholls. Was mentioning this earlier, the Colonels with a win here today will get their 10th conference win. So they get the 2 weeks out of the play. Remain just a half game back of Sam Houston State and Abilene Christian, who both do not play. Bergerson knocks in that first free throw. Lions and Buford come back in for Nicholls. Jones and someone else is not really Lions. Dark as well. But Nicholls, if they can get the 10-2 in South, would be their first time winning back-to-back, winning 10 games in back-to-back years in South Dakota since 1998 and 1999. So you talk about consistency that often costs money with Burgers and Biggs Bowman. This would be an awfully impressive feat, especially given the year it's been. All the COVID-19 protocols, the 25-day shutdown Nicholls had endured, and they're doing a terrific job. Up 13-7, those two free throws from Burgers, and here's Jalen Thorns. Bank shot down there from the top of the arc. Floats it up and in. Nicholls is up 15-7. Perfect start here at home. Now a moving screen. And an offensive foul.
Please.
to a Thorns right corner three. Just how they threw it up, but he missed it. Pinball down, rebound down to Bennett. Up ahead, Jackson Baker slows the right way. Now pushes off against Spencer, blocked the foul ball. Mr. Paul's not too happy in the black pants and great polo on the Nicholls bench. Your head man for the Colonels. Now on Spencer's his first, and team foul number Arkansas won't go very deep to the 8-9 man rotation. Munson and Cooper leave. There's Kyle Luke from the right corner. He knocks down a three. Then that line drive jump we were talking about. Junior from Harris France is on the floor. He only shoots at 29% from the three. That was pure. UCA is back with five. With 12 minutes to go in this first half. Raji Lines, top of the arc for Nicholls. Kevin Johnson now, wearing that left hand, left arm shooting sleeve. Side view from the bounce feed inside Raji Lines. He's Chatham down low. Press the rapid pass around to Spencer. Extra pass Kevin Johnson. Steps inside the arc for two right wing. Ripped it out. Offensive rebound Raji Lines. Power dribble. Lost the ball. Through the legs of Buford. Taken back by Kevin Johnson. Shot clock resets. It was a brief change of possession, so a luxury there for Nicholls. There's Kevin Johnson. Rises right wing for three and rattled it in. Now they go to two. Straddling the three-point arc. I think they'll review that one at the end of the next dead ball. They have it right now. The scoreboard is at three. So it's 17-10. We'll review that one and let you know what the result is on the other side of our next media timeout. Kevin Johnson has been terrific his last couple of games. 14.5 per cup in. Ferguson left corner. Baker catch and shoot triple. That's what he can do. Bury that one. UCA made it before. I mentioned he's been shooting well. 6 of 13 his last couple coming in for a guy who, for the season, is only around 33%. Kevin Johnson against Kyle Luke down the lane, running right-hander. No, tipped up again by Raji Lyons. He's just shaking his head. A beast on the offensive glass is Raji Lyons. 19-13, the lead a half dozen for Nicholls. 10-40, rolling first half clock. To go in the first half here in Nicholls 19, Central Arkansas 13. The Arkansas have pulled off a little bit down to 41%. He's still leading by 6 in the first quarter.
All basketball events. From the same view of those around the place, stay matched up. Thank you for your cooperation and vote of Burns. Hey, Colonel fans, please direct your attention to the video board. Congratulations to Chip Blazoff. He has been selected as our fan cutout of the week. Thank you for your support of Nicholls Athletics. If you want to be the fan cutout of the week, make sure to leave us a note for completing your transactions. To purchase, please visit gocurls.com/fancut.
Stripped up. It's well done defensively by the junior Harris. Inside he goes, outside Burgers, left wing launches up a straight for UCA. And the backup is single point. 9:47 to go. This first half, UCA being chased by Ferguson. 2-3-4, 2-3-3-point right now. I was mentioning DeAndre Jones. The fact that he's been out is a little less than Ferguson has had so much from his play. He's an incredibly talented player, 6'6", 205 senior. He spent 2 years at BYU, but he got Anthony Boone asking to score the ball. He has to score pretty much 20 a game. And then he's going to dish it out. He's averaging 4.5 assists per game. Didn't make sense of it. UCA was much better last year. He went 9-11. DeAndre Jones, of course, is the point guard. He only had to average about 2 assists per game because he could play off the ball. So his usage rate has skyrocketed. You got to credit him for the way that he's played and kept this team at least in some of the games. Right now, UCA with some force and some energy these last couple minutes in the back of the clock. 9.5 to play first half. Nicholls works against the 2-3 zone. Ty Gordon, right wing for three. Off back iron, rebound, Shattuck. UCA can take its first lead and get the basket here. Scored 5 in a row on the move. Lob it down. What a pin! Oh, and he's short right over the top of Garvin for a two-handed flush. Off an alley-oop dive from Bergerson. Wow! 7 in a row for UCA to take a 1-point lead. 20-19, approaching 9 to go first half. That was impressive. Najee Garvin, left wing. This is Andre Jones. Drives the baseline, cut off by Kyle Lutie. Struck him again. Second steal for Kyle Lutie. Jones hustles back inside Bennett. Drives in. No offensive foul. They missed the layup anyway. But Ty Gordon steps in to take the charge. So foul on.
The foul number 13.
Picking it up, and that is his first and the third of the half on UCA. Only 5 combined fouls so far. We've only seen 2 free throws between the two teams. But my God, great job. 8:45, first half clock, 2019 lead for UCA. Gordon between the rings, Najee lines. Holding against the feisty defense of Chad. It was given up by 4 inches aside. Now it's Jones, back to Garvin, inside, reverse layup, missed it. Backboard rim, and then wheels off. And here comes UCA with a 1-point lead. Colin Cooper, ball, free throw on a jump shot. Right, barely grazed the rim, if not an air ball. And scoots toward the stanchion, and it goes back to Nicholls. Messiah Lolo carry checks in. He replaces Bergerson. He gets a rest. He doesn't get many of those. He averages 33.5 minutes per game, third in the Southland Conference. The leading scorer, the leading assist man, one of the highest usage rates in the conference. So he gets a breather with his team up 1-8-20 to go. It's Johnson with Gordon Jones, 4 to the Lions. Nicholls down a point there. And a 1:45 scoring throw. Kevin Johnson works the right hand dribble, the right wing, lob it down, low Najee Lyons. Tough catch. Knocked away, got it back, shot no good. Rebound again, put up off the glass, and into the foul. That is just persistence personified. And a chance for 3 for the big man Nicholls back on top by 1. Najee Lyons on his senior day is off to an aggressive start. 9 points on his 4-5 shooting, 9 of the Nicholls 21. He's had 5 rebounds as well. He keeps this pace, he'll have a first half double-double. Najee for the season at the free throw line at 69.5%, but he's made 14 of his last 17, making 15 of 18. So he's shooting the ball over the last couple weeks, right around 83% or so at the line. That'll work for a guy whose career is only 63%. Nicholls by and Deuce, 22-20. Our next stoppage will be the under 8. Basket doesn't take it. Outside a low carry. Back to Baker, right wing, to splash home a triple. And he yells a roar on the bench. Baker's got 2 threes on 2 drives. And UCA's back up a point. 23-22. 7:35 to go first half. Kevin Johnson around the Lions screen. Left wing, Jalen Forbes. 15 per his last 3. Down low Lions. 10 first half points already. Misses a righty up. Off back iron, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Najee, they say. So UCA's got the ball on the return. The Bears have connected on 6 of their last 7 shots from the floor. They started 2-9. All up 50% now for the game. They lead them 5 points. 23-22. 7:23 go. They open half in Thibodeau.
The Colonel's ball to Nicholls tickets. University tickets.
Attention, Colonel baseball fans. Tickets for opening weekend are on sale now. Be at the Den tonight and Sunday at the Colonel's table on Eastman, Illinois University. More information and purchase your tickets. Call 985-448-4790 or log on to NicholsTickets.universityTickets.com.
Rebounds already. He made his first free throw today. He's made 14 of his last 19. 16 of 19. That percentage, he's over 70 now for the season. He came in at 69%. Malolo carry leaves. And Felipe Bennett comes back in for UCA. One more free throw for the big man. He's got double figures this year. He knocks them both. 1 point, Nicholls lead 30-26. 5:27 to go open half. Garvin back in. Andre Jones 6. So Nicholls goes with that big fight. Garvin. Raji Lyons, along with Spencer, Gordon, and Jackson. Cooper ends with the left hand on the right wing for UCA. Down 4, 5:14 to go first half. Kyle Ode, left wing, rises for 3. Actually, that is a 2-3. He misses off that guy. Offensive rebound, though, cracked down by Kyle Ode. And a fresh 20-second shot clock for UCA. Cooper has a switch. He wants to take Lyons off the bounce. At the top of the arc, sizes him up, rises for 3, and pulls it. That was pure. Looking strong from Colin Cooper, who entered at 32% from three. UCA's back with that point. 30-29, 4:47 to go first half. Ty Gordon on a deep break from three, and it's all net. So the senior from Tunica, Mississippi, eating up 9 first half points there. I think it was led by 4, 33-29. As Cooper, back go feed to 2, went up for a dunk block by Lyons. Quite a block to a guy who comes in second south of Manhattan. 28 first half, 33-29 the lead here for Nicholls. SK Shatou is the free throw shooter. Nigeria, played in high school in Arkansas. Also played a year of ball in Minnesota. Knocks down that first free throw. The guy with the amazing backwards. Freshman season to when he didn't. He lost his freshman season, I should say, 2 years ago. He nearly lost his life when he collapsed in the practice gym. He had that. He was resuscitated by an AED and a defibrillator implanted in his chest the next day. And wasn't cleared for practice for after the 2017-18 season was over. It was really a full year of recovery time. The fact that he's on the court is a miracle in itself. It's great to see him out here in the brigading. He's got a couple free throws. UC is back to 2. Kevin Johnson drives to the baseline and is fouled. Let's see this one.
Foul number 14, Colin Cooper.
It's on Cooper. So Cooper picks up number 1. 17 foul already at UCA. That means 1-1 for Kevin Johnson. 74% free throw shooter this season. First quarter, 79%. This is the front end. Front end and then off. Nicholls' free throw roll is continuing. He might take it 4 today with 1 miss, but this season they have just been playing 66% 2-3 zone look now for Nicholls. You see attacks in the purple jerseys to our right. Inside the 2, right hand up. Partially blocked, I think, by Lyons. Rebound Garvin. Here comes Nicholls. This game has slowed down considerably these last couple minutes. After a fast moving first 15 minutes or so. Roger Lyons, top of the arc. Takes a dribble hand up to Ty Gordon. Terminates on the left wing, hands off for Jalen Forbes. Who uses the screen to work to the left corner. Crosses over on Ferguson, takes him inside. Drives down and backs it home. He is such a way of using angles. He used some English on that one with the right hand and the left side to spin it home. And Forbes gets his first field goal. Nicholls goes up 4. 35-31. Forbes has just been sensational these past 5 games. 15 points per his past 3 coming in. Colin Cooper left wide open top. Not a great idea with the way he shot the first one. That one misses off the right. Rebound Lyons. Here comes Nicholls with a 4-point lead. Kevin Johnson top of the arc. The basket here. Nicholls can take its largest lead. Raji Lyons straight away 3. Right, a miss. That's off the Raji Lyons shot. Colin Cooper races out of the back of the rebound. Right wing Ferguson catches a shoot triple off the left. Offensive rebound pulled down by Shatou. They'll reset to Bennett. Right wing, top step in the lane, goes up and under, floater, no, pulled around. And Byron in row. And the rebound down to Gordon, left wing, he wants a 3. That one spins out. The teams have gotten cold. They're a combined, let's see, 2 for their last 14 combined. Nicholls is 1 for the last 9. 2:30 to go. Both coaches just hoping the teams can put a ball in the basket. by Kevin Johnson. And Nicholls get a bucket here and turnover. It's turned into a pickup game here at local YMCA. Bennett, free throw line, jump shot, take rim, no. Rebound tipped out of bounds. Goes back to Nicholls. That's one of the uglier sequences of basketball you'll see at the Division I level. We'll take a break and a well-deserved one, much needed time, I should say. Nicholls 35, UCA 31. 2:07 to go, first half in Thibodeau on the Colonel Sports Radio Network.
Thanks to our proud supporters on the hook. Colonel Tulum came in and placed delivery of the game bags throughout the gym before the game. Hopefully you were one of the lucky winners and found one in your seat. Thanks to Off the Hook for being the official Cajun restaurant and proud supporter of the Colonel.
UCA 34.5% shooting. They were 6 of 13 from 3, which kept them Niners. We'll take a break coming up at halftime. In case you missed it during last night's football game, the opener against Lakers, which Nicholls won in record fashion, a school record 87 points, 7-3 win over Lincoln University in Missouri. Had a chance to catch up with Nicholls Director of Athletics, Jonathan J.T. Terrell, to discuss the return to football, all the pandemic policies, and just generally what it's been like and what the future might offer this department. So stick around for that. It's a replay of last night's interview. We were talking before the game, but still relevant here today. Again, Jonathan J.T. Terrell, Nicholls ED, up next at halftime. Your halftime score, Nicholls 37 and UCA 30 on the Kerbal Sports Radio Network.
Attention Colonel baseball fans, tickets for opening weekend are on sale now. Be at the inn tonight and Sunday as the Colonels take on Eastern Illinois University. For more information and purchase your tickets, call 985-448-4790 or log on to nicholstickets.universitytickets.com. Make sure you stay up to the minute with Colonel Athletics on social media. Visit us at Go Colonels on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and Facebook. Be sure to check out our latest videos at youtube.com/NicholsAthletics. Colonel fans, even if you can't make it to the game, you don't have to miss a second of the action. Register for Colonel's All Access and watch games live right from your computer and mobile device, including select road games. Daily, monthly, and yearly subscription packages are available. Log on to gocolonels.com and register for Colonel's All Access today and never miss another book. If you're looking for the latest Colonels news, updated stats, player and coach bios, merchandise, live video, or anything about the Colonels you're looking for, GoColonels.com. The official website of Nicholls Athletics gives you all the info you crave and more. That's GEAUX, GoColonels.com. Nicholls student athletes need your help to fulfill their academic and athletic dreams. Call the Colonel Athletic Association at 985-448-4010. Find out how to become a member and enjoy some great benefits. Colonel fans, want to stay up to the minute of Nicholls Athletic events? Download the new Nicholls Fan app in the App Store by searching Nicholls Athletics. This app will allow you to check scores, learn all about your favorite players and coaches, and stay updated on all things Nicholls Athletics. Download the app and don't miss a second of the action while supporting your purpose.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jones get the room in the open.
receiving number 13, Eddie Kyler.
Thank you.
The line shooter for the Colonels, number 13, Andre Jones.
Roberson sits down and gets a good point. Lowell carry back on for UCA.
And in the game for UCA, number 5, Asai Owusu. And in the game for UCLA, number 25, Pierce Spencer.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And your final score, Turner 79, UCA 68. Once again, February 20th, as the men's basketball team takes on Houston Baptist, starting at 7 p.m. right here at Stover Gym.
Continuing to take as much pride on that.